We lifted our anchor, we ran the boat back north in search of a protected bay in the southern part of the San Juans, and we knew at that point that our chances of catching a halibut on this trip had basically dropped to zero. But we found a protected bay on the south side of Lopez, and while we continued to fish, we turned our attention from serious fishing to seriously ribbing each other about previous derbies that we had all competed in.
Chuck, what did you think about your buddy Mike Sims winning the Rush Harbor Classic?
I was really happy for him. Got any other questions?
How about the spot he chose to fish?
I thought he used some good judgment in his coming to his decisions.
So what did you do the day before?
Well, we pretty much cruised all of the San Juan Islands and stumbled into some bait in Hicks Bay, put the rods down, and we boated 8 fish in 3 hours. Pretty much made our decision for us where we were going to go. I believe we shared that information with some friends. That's all I got to say about that. Hey, Brad, is it true your skipper likes to fall in the water once in a while? My skipper falls down as much as I do.
Well, we ended this adventure with a shortage of halibut, but certainly no shortage of good laughs. Not every adventure ends with a trophy, but they all end with something more valuable: the experience and camaraderie of good friends sharing a passion for the outdoors and the sporting life we all love. Thanks for joining me on this episode of San Juan Sportsman. I'll be seeing you on the water, in the field, or on the range.
Oh, this is who I am. The way I walk. The way I dress. Woo, that's the way I talk. Come on, Roy. Talk to him. Woo. Good God Almighty.
I heard the skipper was tough, and I had a little bit of an initiation, and they cut my hair off, and they forced me to put that on my hands.
How did that make you feel?
I'm gonna go lay in the field position down below.